Hello everyone and welcome to our channel. Today I'm gonna show you how to make this beautiful backpack. I really like the pattern because it's really customizable and all the backpacks are so comfortable. I watched some videos and some patterns in Pinterest and think that I can make one for myself. This pattern is made by me because I was watching videos and after that I just decided that I have to try this. It's really customizable, as I said, in colors or in sizes. Because here I use 3 different colors, but you can use less or more. It depends on you. Here you can see I have a handles. They are 60 centimeters. Here is the flap. It's with different color. You can see here the little detail of the third color. I really like it. It's really nice. You can see. I want to tell you the dimensions of the backpack. The height is 32 centimeters. The weight is 12 centimeters. And the height of the backpack is 28 centimeters. I just want to show you that this backpack looks smaller, but when you open it, you will see that it's really big. I prefer it to be big because I'm always with so much stuff and need more space in my bag. For this, I use a 2-part fastener. I will show you now. You can see. I just sew them up to the back. One to the flap. Here and the other one here. I just love to feel secure when I'm walking on the streets and this makes me comfortable. You can see the flap here. I put 2 strings of yarn so it's more easier and comfortable when you open and close your bag. Now I will show you inside because it's really big after you open it. There is too much space for everything you wish to put. I just made 1 pocket inside. For the inside part I use fabric yarn. Fabric lining. You can see. For me it's better with fabric because it's beautiful. Well, someone can prefer without, but for me the better is with fabric lining. Now I will show you. You can see the dimension is changing when you close the bag like this. It's really customizable pattern because if you want you can make it with a smaller size. The only thing that you have to do is when you increase down in the bottom, you will start with less single crochets and then you increase less rows than I will do in this video. After that we have 2 times increase here. In the backpack, if you want, there is no problem. You don't need to do the same increase here. It will be more flat here. And after we shape our backpack, you will see the difference. You can see when you put this a bit inside, you will see that it's changing. It looks smaller, but inside you still have enough space to put all your stuff and to carry them with you. For the handles, my handles are 60 centimeters, but after you tension them, you have to take the centimeter and just tension the handles and after that to see how much centimeters it is. Because when you look like this, it's smaller, but it's enough because when you put something inside the bag, you know it will tension more. And for me, 60 centimeters is perfect. If you want, of course, you can make it less or you can make it much longer. It depends again on you. The colors, again, I just use 3 different colors, but you can use less or more. It's up to you, it's customizable. A really nice pattern. I really try maybe 1 week to make this beautiful backpack, because always there's a problem which I didn't like on the pattern or on the backpack, and in the end you can see the backpack's looking like this. So if you are ready, we can start with our pattern. For this pattern we will use 2 balls of fabric yarn, t-shirt yarn or macaroni, it's all the same. It's cotton yarn, 90% cotton and 10% polyester. As I told you, we will need 2-part fastener. You can use different, but for me this is the better and looks good on this backpack. I will need a scissor because I will change colors. If you are not changing colors for the beginning, you don't need these scissors. And I will use 10 millimeters hook. If you are ready, we can start crocheting our bag. In this pattern, we will start by chaining 12. So let's start. We will count this as a chain. Remember this. 2, 3, 4. Now insert the hook into the third chain of the hook here. 1, 2, 3 here, and make one single crochet. Then repeat the same till the end of the last stitch here. Don't tie too much, tie it too much. Here we will make 3 single crochet in the same chain. Insert the hook, yarn over. 1, 2, and 3. Then turn your work into opposite side and continue working in this side. Again, we will make single crochet till the end of this row. Now we will make 3 single crochet in the same chain. If you remember, in the beginning we made our first single crochet in the third loop of the hook. So here we will make 1 single crochet in the chain of this chain 2 here. One, 2, and 3. You can see how our bottom is shaping. Now the joining will be here in the first single crochet. Join with slip stitch. Our first row is done. The second row is chain 2, make 1 single crochet in next stitch. And repeat this till the end of this row. When you came here where we made 3 single crochet, I will show you what we will do. We will make our increase. So I came to the stitch where we made 3 single crochet. Now we will make our increases. We will make 2 single crochet in each of these 3 stitches. 2 single crochet, 2 single crochet, and 2 single crochet again. Now we will make 1 single crochet again till these 3 stitches where we will increase. We will make 2 single crochet, 2 single crochet and 2 single crochet here. This is not count as a stitch. Now we will join again with slip stitch in the first single crochet here. In oval form, you can see. If it's not the same shape, then you made mistake somewhere in the pattern. Don't worry, you can see it's shapeless at the moment, but in the end when we finish our bottom and start the body part of the backpack, it will be okay. Now we will continue with our third row. Chain 2 and again make 1 single crochet in next stitch. Repeat this till our increase here. Now, you can see in the previous row we made 2 single crochet in the same chain. Now we will make 1 single crochet, increase, 1 single crochet, increase, 1 single crochet, increase. One single crochet, increase, 3 single crochet. I want to repeat again. 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet, 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet, 1 single crochet, 3 single crochet. Because we made 3 single crochet in same chain in the first row, we will increase by 3 stitches. So in the second row we made 2 single crochet, 2 single crochet, 2 single crochet, 3 times. Here we will make 1 single crochet in next stitch, 2 single crochet in next stitch. If you use thinner t-shirt yarn, your size will be smaller. Or if you use bigger t-shirt yarn, then your size will be bigger. I want to tell you this because there's some ways to increase our bottom. You can start with less chain and you can increase again by 3 stitches, or you can make less increase rows in the bottom, so you can find the perfect size for your bag. I just want to show you that there is a big difference in some t-shirt yarns. Here is which I'm working now, and you can see the second one. There is a difference. This is the thinner and this is bigger than the other one, you can see. So the sizes will be different. Let's continue. Again, one single crochet till the stitches where we increase. Now again, one single crochet increase, one single crochet increase, one single crochet increase. As I told you before, this is not count as a stitch here. You have to increase by 3 times, 1, 2 and 3. Now again, I will join my row here in the first single crochet with slip stitch. You can see, if you get this shape, everything is okay. Now I will change the color because I want to show you the difference between the thinner and the other t-shirt yarn, so you can see. And if you find a t-shirt yarn, you can easily choose one for you. I take my bigger yarn, make the slip stitch again. Now chain 2 again. 1. Sorry. And 2. With the bigger yarn, it's more difficult to work. I think it's good to know this. It's a bit harder. Again, we'll make one single crochet in next stitch. And we will continue here again. Now, in this row, we'll increase by 2 single crochet in next 2 stitches, after that 1 single crochet in next stitch, 2 single crochet in next stitches, 2 single crochet in next stitch, 2 single crochet in next 2 stitches, 2 single crochet in next stitch. Let's continue and make our single crochets till the increases. Now here we will make 2 single crochet in same stitch to make our first increase. I just really want to show you the difference. The stitches are bigger. You can see the difference. Let's continue again, single crochet till the increases. Two single crochet increase. Join again with slip stitch to the first single crochet here. This is our bottom part of our backpack. Now I will show you how to make the body of the backpack. Before I start the body of the backpack, I just want to show you the difference in the sizes. Here is my first bag, which you will see on the pictures, and now you can see it looks smaller. So if you want to make the same size like this bag, you have to make one more increase row before you start the body of the backpack. Here I have one from this size, so I just want to make one smaller, and this video will help me to make one for myself. Here again I just want to show you it's smaller. Now we can continue to our body. When we start to make the body, we will make only two increases in the both two sides. One will be here in the last increase, the last stitch of our last increase, and one will be in the beginning of our increase here. It will be the same for the other side. We will increase only by two sides of the bottom, one here and one here. For the first row of the body, we will work only in the back loops. Chain two, two, make one single crochet in back loops only. We'll work only in back loops in next stitch. Chain one, skip next stitch and make one single crochet again here in back loop. Chain one, skip next stitch, one single crochet in back loop of the next. You can see we have a little holes, chain space here, chain again, skip next stitch, one single crochet, chain one, skip next stitch, one single crochet. chain one and now we will increase here in the first stitch of previous increase. The increasing is one single crochet, chain one, and one single crochet again in same stitch. We have one hole here, chain one space, and we have one chain space here. This is the increase of this stitch. Again, chain one, skip next stitch, one single crochet. Chain one, skip next stitch, one single crochet. Chain one, skip next stitch, one single crochet. Chain one, skip next stitch, one single crochet here, and we will make the increase again here. Chain one and make one single crochet in chain in the same stitch. This is the increase. So you can see we make two increases only in the both sides of the backpack. One here and one here. We will make the same for the other side. Chain one and make increase. Chain one and make one single crochet in same stitch. Increase here. One single crochet. Chain one. One single crochet in same stitch. Chain one and join to the first single crochet here. Chain two, which we made in the beginning of the row, doesn't count as a stitch. In the next row, we will not increase. So we turn our work. Now chain two again. This time make one single crochet in the chain one space of the previous row here. Chain one again, one single crochet in the next chain one space. In the end of the second row of the body, I made the last single crochet. Now I will chain one and will join to the first single crochet here. Chain two in the beginning of the row doesn't count as a stitch. We will join to the first single crochet here. Now, for the third row, chain two, make one single crochet in next chain one space again. Chain one single crochet. Chain one single crochet again in the next chain space. In this third row, we will make increase again. As you can see, we make increase here and one here in the both sides of the backpack. Now we will make again one increase here and one here. It will be the same for the other side. You can see here and here, here and here. You can mark your first increase and you just only need to be sure that you have to make the next increase here. First increase here, the next here. So chain one single crochet again, chain one, and now we will make our increase here. One single crochet, chain one, one single crochet in the next. And now you can see again, the first increase is here and the next is here. First, the second. We will make the same for the other side. The first increase is here, the next is here. The first one is here, the next one is here. The first one is here, the next one is here. I will finish this row and I will show you the last row, which will continue to the desired length, to the desired height of our bag. To get the desired length of the backpack, you need to repeat this row till the length you want. In my backpack, which I showed you on the picture, I made 17 more rows from this row, which I will show you. It's the same like the second one. Chain two, Make one single crochet in next chain one space. Chain one single crochet in next chain space. After these first three rows, you don't need to increase anymore. In the end, when you get the desired length of the backpack, you will see how it will turn and how it will shape. You can see even here, it's almost shaped. This will be put inside and will make the look of the backpack, the woof here. You can see this part of the backpack. So as I told you, don't worry if the shape is different or it's not okay for you. The only thing you need to know, if you get this shape of the bottom, everything is okay. When you finish the height, you will see that the whole backpack will get the shape you want. As I told you, in the first bag I made 17 more rows, but I think here I will need maybe 14 or 15. In the end, when your body is finished, you have to see how it will look like. It's different from the backpack, but when you put the string, it will take the shape we want. For this backpack, I made 14 more rows. Remember, we increased one time in the first row of the body and in the third round of the body. So after the last increase row, I made 14 more rows. You can see I changed the color, and after that I put the string. Now I will take the string and shape the backpack. You can see if you like this shape, you can use it like this, but I'm not prefer this shape. So when you put it a bit in, you will see our backpack is ready, the body is ready. Even like this, I like the pattern. You can put only handles here and it can be like a little bag, not a backpack, but bag which you can use. As you can see, the flap of the backpack again is customizable. You can make it smaller, higher or bigger. It depends on you how you like it. Our second bag is smaller, so I will make it a bit smaller than this one, which I show you now. Here I make the start with chaining 12, after that make 10 single crochet, and in the last stitch I make 3 single crochet in same stitch. The next rows are increasing rows. Here we make 2 single crochet in same stitch, 1 single crochet increase, 2 single crochet increase, and in the last row we made 3 single crochet and increase. The first two rows are made with single crochet, the third row is half double crochet, and after that again turn in single crochet. The last row of the flap, I will show you this little detail how to make it. Here I finished with the same color, because you can see here I have to sew them and I don't want to have a different color here, which can when I sew them up you can see the difference in the color. This is the better choice for me. So let's start. If you are ready, I will start by chaining 10. 1. Here we have 10 foundation chains. I will make one more. So let's start. 1 single crochet in the second chain from the hook. Here. 1, 2. Repeat this till the last stitch. In the last stitch, remember that we will make 3 single crochet in same stitch. So I'm here in the last stitch, as I told you, we will make 3 single crochet here. You can see. Now we will continue to work in the opposite side here till the last stitch. We will make 1 single crochet in each stitch. You have to insert the hook here. When you are working in the opposite side, you can see here. Again. Now we will not work in a round, but we will chain 2. 1, 2. Turn your work and continue with single crochet till the 3 stitches where we made in the same stitch. Here we will have increase. We will increase in these 3 stitches 3 times. 2 single crochet, 2 single crochet, and 2 single crochet again. Now we are in here where we will start our increase. So 2 single crochet in the same stitch, 2 single crochet in the same stitch, 2 single crochet in the same stitch. You have to increase 3 times. Again, to show you, you can see. This will be the back of the flap, and here is our front. Now I will continue single crochet till the end of the row. In the end of the row, always make 1 single crochet in the beginning chain 2, in the second chain of beginning chain 2, here, so it will be flat. Here. The third row of the flap is half double crochet, chain 2. Turn your work, and this time you will make half double crochet all around. Don't forget here. Now 1 single crochet increase, 1 single crochet increase, 1 single crochet increase. the increase is here. So we made one single crochet, now two single crochet in next stitch. The flap is ready. Now I will show how to make the detail, the last row. You can see I changed the color because I think it will look better with my backpack. For changing color, it's the same. The last row is single crochet. Do not finish the last single crochet. Take the second color, yarn it over the hook, pull it through the loops, and it's ready. You change the color. Now the last row with the little detail, we will start, we'll crochet single crochet the back part of the flap. So I will show chain one. Here is the chain two. We'll make one single crochet here again. When you finish the back part of the flap and make one single crochet all around, we'll continue with the little detail. I will show now. We'll work in back loops only. We will make slip stitch in every stitch around, but only in back loops. When we have increase, we will increase, but not with single crochet or half double crochet, with slip stitch in back loop. It will give us the flat form of the flap. My first increase, you can see. And make one slip stitch here. You can leave a long tail for sewing the flap. And now you will see. if you prefer. You can use it like this, you can see, or if you prefer, it can be like this. The first I made, I chose this side. I really like how it turned out. After you sew them in, leave them in, it will look better. I will show you on the back. It's really nice, I think. This color. You can see our backpack is almost ready. This side, or of course you can use this side, it's up to you. Now I will show you how to make the handles of this backpack. For the handles, you have to start by chaining 3. 1, 2, and 3. Then make one single crochet, but do not finish them. Insert the hook, yarn over, pull through the loop, and do not finish your single crochet. 2 loops on the hook. Insert the hook. Yarn over, pull through the loop. 3 loops on the hook. Now, take off the hook from the first 2 loops, yarn over again, pull through the loop on the hook, insert in the second loop which we take off earlier, again in the third loop, yarn over, pull through. And again we have 3 loops on the hook. After a bit centimeters, after 10 or 3 rows, you will see how it turns out. I will show you again. Take off the first 2 loops of the hook. Yarn over. Pull through the first loop. Insert in the second loop which we take off from the hook. Yarn over. Pull through the loop, 2 loops on the hook, insert in the third, yarn over, pull through, 3 loops on the hook. This is for the handles, the back side. You have to continue as I told you in the beginning of this video. My handles are 60 centimeters, but when you look on the handles, you can see it looks smaller, but when you tighten it, you will see. You have to get the centimeter and see how much it will be in this position, not like this, because when you put something in the bag, you know, it will be more tightened and it will be longer handles. This is for the handles. And I will continue crocheting the handles and will show you how to make the little handle for the backpack. In my previous bags I didn't put, but here I just want to show you because someone can want to make one for himself. The little handle I'm talking about is this one. You can see. Just a second. It's really nice and easy to make this one. It looks difficult, but it's not. I will show you now how to make it. Make one single crochet in the first chain. You can see these two loops here and here. Turn the work, insert the hook here in this loop. Sorry. And make one single crochet. Now turn again, insert the hook into these two loops. Three loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through, and make one single crochet. Turn your work again, two loops, insert the hook into these two loops. Three loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through, make one single crochet. Turn your work, two loops again. After a few more rows, you will see how it will shape. You can see how it turning out. After a few more rows, it will be the same. The result will be the same as the red one. You can make it again as big as you want. The parts of the backpacks are this. Now I will sew the whole parts and I will show you how it will look in the end. As you can see, I sew everything. And our backpack is ready. It's smaller version of the previous one. I just want to open and to see here the handles. I don't have enough yarn from this color and the handles are small. I have to make bigger one because it's not comfortable with this smaller one. Here is the little handle which you can use when you have to take something from the backpack. It's really nice. You can hold it with one hand and find the thing you need from the backpack. I really like the color combination. At the beginning I was not sure how it will look like in the end, but now I can say it's pretty good and I really like how it turns out. Now I will open. I have to leave ends in, but it's not a problem. Here the string which I put earlier. smaller, but it's really comfortable. I really like it. I really need a smaller one. I hope this video was useful for you. I think I said the tips and tricks of t-shirt yarn. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. If you have any questions, just comment below and I will make the best to answer all of your questions. I just want to show you the first bag I made, so you can see the difference between both of them. You can see. This is a bit smaller, this is a bit bigger, with 3 colors, with 2 color combination. The same pattern, the same stitches, but the t-shirt yarn here is a bit bigger and the back is bigger. Here, this gray one was thinner and the backpack is smaller. But I think it's still pretty. The pattern is really customizable. As you can see, you can use the same stitches without trying to make another new one, and you will have 2 different sizes. As I told you, I hope it was useful video for you, and if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel.